Welcome to my virtual over-the-road trucking adventure in Montana. This video is part of a series where we will be exploring Montana, and we'll be exploring Montana by delivering loads to every city on the map, and to the extent practical, driving over every major highway on the map. Today we are in Great Falls, which is where we left off last time. We delivered over here at Cargill in the last video. Now, and by the way, we only have four cities left to discover or deliver to here. So we are going from Great Falls to Bozeman. That is our destination. It is 237 miles. So let's get going. Oh, we are hauling scrap paper, waste paper, basically crushed cardboard boxes. Huh, there's a lot of these kinds of loads. All right, as you may have noticed, let's get going. It's heavy, I guess, so I'll have to start out in first gear instead of second. Yeah, 38,000 plus. Yeah, I guess that was kind of a rolling stop. By the way, I installed GPS there on the left side of my windshield. I think it's the TomTom. Although it looks like it says Garmin on the bottom. It looks an awful lot like my, actually I have a Rand McNally.
Go straight.
Let's see. Go straight. TomTom. It does say TomTom. I didn't realize the speed limit was only 55, and now we got 45 mile an hour curve. And as a truck driver under load, I typically adhere to those recommended speeds, which is what yellow signs are. Caution. Now I've got to watch my top speed here, because this is not a World of Trucks load. So I'm not speed limited. And in fact, we get on more of a straightaway, I can dial up to speed to 70 now. Just like that. But here's a 55 mile an hour curve. We don't need that rest area. We got a full clock and full tank of fuel. Helena! Actually, we haven't been to Helena yet in this exploration. Helena is one of the cities we need to discover. Explore. So we'll need to find a load back here. I looked for a load coming here and couldn't find one. See? Keep pushing wrong buttons. Now we can dial it up to 70 again. So let's see, the cities left to discover is Bozeman, which is where we're headed now. Helena, which we just drove through, so that didn't count. Thompson Falls and Missoula. That's what they mean by keep left. Well, that could have got ugly. About time that red car went around that truck in front of him. I don't know what the heck he was waiting for, an invitation. So we've got a truck speed limit of 45 going down this hill. And that's real. In real life, it's like that. All right, we have cleared that reduced speed. Imagine those cars back there don't appreciate me drifting into their lane. I know I wouldn't. Bozeman, next two exits. Quite sure where we're going. Oh, okay, we're going over here and then down that loading dock area. Nice flatbed trailer. Job. All right, let me scope it out here real quick. Yep. Gonna be on the other side of that other trailer. Thank you. All right, since it's a blind side, let's check again. Yep, this is why we check. I'm too close. It's about to hit that concrete retaining wall. Just see that other trailer out my back window there. Get off my screen. Close enough. There we go. I'll do a little pedangling to get in because it was a blindside back. But we got her done. Okay. Didn't look at the clock. Let me see how much time we have on our clock. 7 hours and some change. So let's take a look at. So we went from Great Falls down through Helena to Bozeman. So we still need to find a load to Helena and Missoula. So we'll check World of Trucks first. Nothing on the World of Truck. So let's go to the cargo market. Man. Well, there's one to Thompson Falls. We do need to go there. Let's go to Thompson Falls. And where are we picking up? South part of town. Looks like we're gonna have to navigate a bunch of traffic lights. Oh wow. Thank you. You know, if necessary, I may have to drop my trailer and use a provided trailer just to get a load to the place we're trying to get to. I was just thinking I need to speed up so I can make that light, and then it turns yellow. Sleep at the wheel. Welcome to Bozeman.
Go straight.
We got us a roundabout. Thompson Falls. How far is that anyway? 263 miles. 4.5 hours.
Yep.
Here's what we're gonna do, because we gotta back into that spot right there. We're gonna get turned around, back in sorta, kinda, well, turned around basically, whatever. Show you what I mean. Before I forget, we don't need the steering axle. To overcorrect. I can do overcorrecting myself. Oh, I could have gone through there. Here's a problem with that. In game, it's not a problem. In real life, I would not drive over that pile of debris. Lord knows how many nails are sticking out of that pile. I learned my lesson from plenty of punctured tires. But in the game, I certainly could drive through there and then swing up and then back in. Absolutely. However, since I'm simulating real life, I'm not going to go that way. Not unless I got farther over so I could avoid that pile of debris. Which actually I could do. Yeah, I can avoid that pile of debris. Just have to be careful not to hit that car. Therein lies the problem. Close. Now I gotta watch out that I don't grab something with my fender over here on the right side. One nice thing about that window down there in the door. And the mirror right there. Now, I do consider it a little bit of a failure going that way because I did run over that pallet debris. And that consequently could have picked up a nail. I mean, just even running anywhere near that pile of debris, I could have picked up a nail. Heck, I could pick up a nail anywhere in here. I have. At places like this. There's our cargo, all strapped down and locked. Okay. How far do we have to go? 236 miles. So we're going back up to the freeway. And we're going to head west to Thompson Falls. Oops. Wrong button. Oh, we're turning right. Lost my situational awareness for a moment. You get a completely different GPS response in ATS, apparently, during roundabouts than you do in Euro Truck Simulator or even in real life. This load is not very heavy. Right, 22,500 pounds.
Keep left, and then turn left. Turn left.
Wrong button again, getting a little muddle-headed. beginning to think I wasn't going to make that light.
Keep left, and then turn left.
Made it. We're going to climb that hill we just came down a little bit ago, and then we're going to descend the other side. I didn't catch that sign. I guess we're a little lighter than he is. And now we've got to slow down. Or at least take it slow. Having a tough time staying in my lane. And I'm not even gawking that much. And we've got a scale coming up. And we gotta go in. Need fuel. How we doing on clock? We got 4 hours. So we're not gonna make it there, so we'll have to find a place to stop. Take a 10-hour break. Before we deliver. Let's check the map and see what we can find. A little ways ahead. Right here. We'll just go in there. That's an hour and 18 minutes away. That'll work. Ooh, we can speed up. The scenery of western Montana.
right, then exit right. Exit right.
There's a beautiful sight to a trucker. A truck stop with lots of parking. At the end of your driving day. Because normally at the end of your driving day, you pull into a place like this and you're lucky to find one or two spots. Although in Montana, my experience has been it's not as bad as like in the Midwest or Northeast. Need fuel, so we're just gonna park. I'll run inside because this place is one of the many places that are famous for their roasted chicken. Okay, I just love me some fried chicken. Probably a little closer than I'd like to be to the next truck over, but this'll work. All right. I'm gonna run in and get me some chicken, and I'll be right back. Oh, I lost my trigger. Now I'll go get chicken. Okay. It is 6:41 a.m. Getting driver reports from overnight. Good enough. So we have 79 miles left to cover from here to there. It's not quite Thompson Falls. I will. I was unaware that the speed limit had dropped to 65. Can't keep it straight.
Keep left.
So we still have to discover Missoula. We may have discovered it, but we need to explore it. Pretty sure. Regis. Thank you.
destination.
Yes, we have. But where are we parking? Ah, over there. In the midst of all that lumber. So we're gonna head up this way, and then we're gonna back through the gate, or the fence, through the fence opening. Let me just clarify that. Gotta watch out for that log. Okay, we've gotten past the log. Let's check and see how we are in relation to the opening in the fence. Bueno. Keep doing what we're doing. Get straightened out a little bit. And that's why we go slow. I actually did bump the building, but only just barely. Late? How late? Oh, I forgot it's not a world of trucks load. I can't just take a break because I feel like taking a break or I'm running out of time. Oh well, still got paid. Still got experience points. I am going to wrap it up here. If you have enjoyed, oh, by the way, this is the Halloween background still. That event is still going on. I have completed it. I even did a live streamed part of it, and live streamed a convoy with some other folks who already completed it. Okay. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe and ring that notification bell so you don't miss out on notifications for future videos. Next time we will book a load out of Thompson Falls, so we'll actually go into Thompson Falls, because we haven't technically discovered it yet, but we will. All right. Thanks for joining me on this trip. We'll do it again real soon.